Local breaking news. This is WYFF News 4 at 6 in high definition.
You could call this the first real test in South Carolina. A South Carolina trooper is calling on the governor to recognize gay marriage. Tonight, the core of the issue and the benefits at stake. Good evening, I'm Carol Goldsmith.
And Michael Cogdill, it's a first-of-its-kind lawsuit in South Carolina, a state trooper challenging the state law against gay marriage.
News 4's Angela Rodriguez is here on the story. Angela, she's fighting for benefits?
That's really what's at stake for this family. Catherine Braddock is legally married, but if she were to get killed in the line of duty, her family would not qualify for state death benefits under South Carolina law.
Katie Braddock and her partner Tracy Goodwin are loving mothers who were legally married in Washington, D.C. last April. The Supreme Court ruling on the Defense of Marriage Act has given them the courage to launch a landmark case here in South Carolina.
South Carolina is a fairly conservative state, but it's progressive in a lot of ways. And it's our belief and our faith that the court will take a look at the changing views around the country and the changing views in our state.
Katie and Tracy claim they are treated as legal strangers under state law. Katie, the woman on your right, protects strangers as a state trooper. But because gay marriage is not recognized in South Carolina, as a mother, she cannot fully protect her family. Both her children are on Medicaid because state insurance won't cover them, and state death benefits are not an option for this family. Same goes for tax and Social Security benefits. They believe their only option left is to fight for equal protection afforded by the 14th Amendment.
Governor Nikki Haley and Attorney General Alan Wilson are both named in the suit. The governor's office issued this statement today. Governor Haley, like the majority of South Carolinians, supports traditional marriage as defined between one man and one woman. And in accordance with state law, will continue to uphold these values. The legislature has spoken on the issue, the people have spoken on this issue, and the governor remains resolute in her support of South Carolina's constitution and states' rights. And this lawsuit doesn't change that. Michael?
Angela, thank you. Former Oconee County Sheriff's candidate James Bartee has been found guilty of plotting to kidnap a former judge. News 4's Mandy Gaither is live and local outside the Oconee County Courthouse tonight. Mandy, what happens now?
An appeal is already being planned. Bartee and his attorney were both stunned by the verdict.
As to indictment, 2012 GS-37597, solicitation to commit a felony. Unanimously find the defendant guilty.
It took just over 2 hours for a jury to find former Oconee County Sheriff's candidate James Bartee guilty of plotting to kidnap former Judge Jimmy Williams. Williams had filed a legal complaint alleging Bartee did not meet the requirements needed to run for sheriff. Because of that complaint and the fact that Bartee had spent $76,000 of his own money on his campaign, prosecutors say Bartee became desperate. Bartee showed little emotion after the verdict, but had a chance to talk to the judge before his sentencing. Bartee's family cried as the judge handed down the sentence. Bartee will spend 5 years in prison with 5 years probation and 250 hours of community service afterwards. After the verdict, defense attorney Doug Brannon stood by his client.
He's not guilty.
What do you plan to do next?
File notice of appeal.
Were you surprised by this verdict?
Can't you tell?
Solicitor Chrissy Adams says she believes the audio tape between Bartee and confidential informant Nick Blackwell was the most damaging for the defense.
We feel that the evidence spoke for itself. The jury obviously agreed that it did, and it was the correct verdict based on the evidence.
A judge denied a request that would have allowed Bartee to bond out during the appeals process, so Bartee is heading to prison.
And part of the sentence, the judge also ordered Bartee to undergo a psychiatric evaluation. Mandy Gaither, WYFF News 4, live in Oconee County.
Okay, thank you, Mandy. A former attorney for the Greenville County Schools may be allowed to practice law again here years after being accused of child sex crimes. The state Supreme Court says Wade Cleveland can be reinstated to the South Carolina bar. Cleveland was charged with sexual exploitation of a minor and computer crimes back in 2007. The charges were dropped in 2010 because investigators said they couldn't prove the people in the videos and pictures on his computer were under the age of 18. His interim suspension has been lifted, and the high court says, in fact, Cleveland may be reinstated to the bar.
Spartanburg County deputies upgraded charges today against a Woodruff man accused in a deadly shooting. Deputies say Terrell Brown shot LaQuentin Yergin and Nahirian Parks around midnight Sunday night at the Kelly Acres Apartments. Parks died early Monday morning. Yergin died early this morning. Instead of murder and attempted murder, Brown faces two murder charges now. Deputies arrested Brown in the Woodruff Road area in Greenville yesterday morning. He is being held in the Spartanburg County Jail. New information tonight about the fatal shooting of a store employee Friday night. This was at Illusion's Smoke Shop on Poinsett Highway. Tonight we've learned the new owners of the business hadn't been open a full week before this happened. News 4's Sean Mazzarello with the details.
The doors are locked. They're still closed. Customers who came by the smoke shop Tuesday morning say they don't blame them for not being open.
Probably best, they probably still in mourning.
Investigators say the gunman walked into the store and shot and killed an employee. The victim was identified as 29-year-old Theodore McClellan. A person who works nearby in the shopping center but did not want to identify themselves told me that two brothers just bought the smoke shop less than a week before the shooting. He said that the previous owner left the shop and sold it because he had a bad feeling and wanted to start a new business two storefronts down. The person also told me the shooting was over an argument earlier in the day between the suspect and employee. Sean Mazzarello, WYFF News 4, Greenville County.
Greenville County investigators say there was not an official update on this case when asked about what we learned. If you have information that could lead to an arrest, you're asked to call Crime Stoppers at 23 Crime.
Now to a story of stolen goods, thousands of dollars worth. Tonight, Greenville County deputies are looking for your help to find the thief. Here now is News 4's Nigel Robertson.
We are at 9 Saluda Dam Road at the public storage facility behind me. Deputies say over the weekend they got reports that 5 units had been broken into. I'm going to step out of the way so you can get a better idea of what we're looking at. Clearly, whoever got into these units had to go over the fence and then break the lock to the individual units. One unit, we're told only $20 worth of goods were stolen, but some of the others, we got $1,950. $30,000 in another, $50,000 in yet another. We are told investigators are looking at evidence from the scene, trying to figure out exactly when these crimes took place and who's behind them. If you know anything, you're asked to call Crime Stoppers at 23 Crime. Nigel Robertson, WYFF News 4, Greenville County.
Visitation is being held right now for Duncan Mayor John Hamby. Stribling Funeral Home tells us Mayor Hamby died on Sunday. He was 75 years old. Visitation is at the Stribling Funeral Home. It goes on until 8 tonight. The funeral will be held at 11 o'clock tomorrow morning at Duncan First Baptist Church. Burial will follow at Wood Memorial Park in Duncan.